though, you can still go. Hey everybody, welcome back to the Champions for Christ Christian Church Bookwork. That's right, this is all bookwork, and we do this on Wednesdays leading up to Christmas, and we are talking about Advent. And in our Advent, we have talked about hope, we've talked about the preparation, and now we're talking about the joy. So when it comes to Jesus, we put our hope in Jesus. We prepared for Jesus. We prepared for the birth of Jesus. We prepared for the second coming of Jesus. And today, I just want to talk very briefly about the joy that we have in Jesus. That's right. I want to talk about the joy that we have in Jesus. How many of you know that there's joy in Jesus? You know, one of my favorite Bible verses talks about the joy of the Lord being our strength. That's right. That was found in Nehemiah, the 8th chapter, the 10th verse. And we called it the B clause because it was the second half of that verse. And it says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. And, you know, what it tells me and what it tells you and what it tells all of us when we think about this is we get joy in having the strength of the Lord. Because it said, the joy of my strength, the joy of the Lord is my strength. And it just, I get joy thinking about the Lord. I get joy thinking about what all he's done. I get joy thinking about what all he can do. And that's where my strength comes from. That's where my strength comes from. And those of us who follow the faith of Christianity, that's where our faith comes from. Our faith comes from the strength of the Lord. Some like to think that they're strong and mighty and all that. We might be, but it's not our strength. It's the strength of the Lord. And, you know, let me say this too. I have another verse that talks about weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. And that's the because also. And that's saying, you know, what's so interesting about that whole thing? That's the because of Psalm 30. Well, I guess if I'm giving the because, I'm not going to give you the A because of this one, because it says, for his anger is but for a moment, and his favor is for a lifetime. That's right. His anger is for a moment, but his favor is for a lifetime. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. You know, last night, I'm from the state of Georgia. Most of y'all probably know this if you watch any of my videos. And in particular, I'm from the A. So last night, as I went to bed, I wasn't weeping or crying, but I was feeling some kind of way. But when I woke up this morning, there was joy that came in the morning in the form of congratulations to the new state senator, the new U.S. senator from the state of Georgia, the Reverend Dr. Raphael Warnock. Congratulations to him. And I say that because as a state and as a resident, and especially us being in the Bible Belt, we are Christians here in the state of Georgia. And sometimes we might not all think the same, but I thank God that God allowed the victory for the one who is the person for this time. So yes, weeping may endure for a night, but joy came this morning. But joy didn't only come in the form of an elected U.S. senator from the state of Georgia by the name of the Reverend Dr. Raphael Warnock. Joy came in the morning. See, joy came in the morning because we woke up. We had the activity of our limbs. We had the functions of our bodies. We were thinking in our right mind. And the same thing happened to a lot of us, if you think about it, when we were kids. And how we would go to bed with so much excitement. We weren't weeping when we went to bed, but when we got up, joy came on Christmas morning because a lot of us, we were able to go down and get our toys and things like that or whatever we did to get ready to celebrate Jesus' birth on Christmas Day as we know it, December 25th. But let me share this. Let me share this. So one of the things about joy, you know, I said, weeping may endure for a night, joy comes in the morning. I told you my other one about how the joy of the Lord is my strength. And, you know, there's another one found in John 15 and 11. It says, these things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be full, and some like to say complete. That's good news when we think about joy. When we think about joy, that's good news, because when we think about that, there's just so much, and joy is Yes, it makes us feel good. It brings us happiness. But joy is about thinking of the goodness of the Lord, thinking of the strength of the Lord and what all he did and what all had to happen for him to let his son, his only begotten son, Jesus the Christ, come from heaven to earth, walk the face of the earth, live among us, and get to the cross of Calvary, down the cross of Calvary. And that wasn't the end of the story. The end of the story was he rose again, and he had all power in his hand. And as he walked the face of the earth, as he rose again, he told his disciples he would go and prepare a place for us, and he would return to get us. That's something to be joyful about. You know, one of the first songs I learned as a Christmas song as a kid growing up was Joy to the World. And most of y'all know it. It said, Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her king. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. So we see that joy came to the world because the Lord came. And earth received her king. And not only earth, but it says heaven and nature. Heaven and nature sing. So what are you singing this morning? What are you singing this afternoon? What are you singing this evening? What are you singing tonight? Are you singing about the joy of the Lord? Kirk Franklin told us joy, joy, God's great joy. And you know, there's something about all these joy songs, these joy scriptures. And okay, I even throw in one of my favorite candy bars when I used to eat candy, like Almond Joy. Yes, I went out there and threw in a candy bar, Almond Joy, but it's sweet. Just like they say, Jesus is sweeter than the day before. That's because we have joy. So as we get ready to celebrate this third principle and this third week of our Advent season, we talked about hope. We talked about preparation. Now we talked about joy. I want you to have joy. Joy unspeakable. That kind of joy that you just get so caught up sometimes that you don't even know what to say to describe the joy that you are feeling. Do you have joy? If not, I want to pray that the joy of the Lord will be your strength as well as my strength and as well as all of our strength, because there's enough joy to go around for all of us. So as we get ready to anticipate and look forward to December 25th, the day that we celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, do so with hope, do so with preparation, and do so with joy. And thank you so much for tuning in to the Champions for Christ Christian Church as we talked about Advent doing this bookwork. And again, bookwork is nothing but our Bible study. And this time we talked about joy. But before you go, let me introduce you to our merchandise. We have all type of Be Better on Purpose, Choose Joy with Tisa, the Good News. As a matter of fact, the Good News is our parent company for our platform and our branding. But Champions for Christ, Choose Joy with Tisa, The Good News, Be Better on Purpose. These are all merchandise, cups and caps and hoodies and tees and anything you can think of. We want you all to get these things and help us promote the good news of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ through the church, Champions for Christ Christian Church, and through Be Better on Purpose, Choose Joy with Tisa, and our parent, The Good News. God, that's what Jesus brought to each and every one of us. The good news that we have the right to the tree of life. He saved us from a dying and a burning hell. He reconnected us with his Father God, and he came so we might have the right to the tree of life. And if you don't know him as your Lord and Savior, take this time right now. And if you want to have Jesus in your life, just say that I accept Jesus. I believe in Jesus, and I confess Jesus is Lord and Savior over my life. And if you just said that, you have been saved, and Jesus is Lord and Savior over your life. So until we're together again, good day and good night. Peace.